Not many people know my story, and no one's really asked. I have a younger brother and sister. We're not dirt poor, but try to imagine a single mother with three kids trying to provide food for her kids and make ends meet at the same time. I didn't have a lot of any friends actually come into my house. I was too embarrassed to bring them over. Not because my house wasn't nice, but because I didn't have my own room. I didn't have anywhere to take them. There was nothing to do at my house. As a young child, I felt good playing basketball. I wasn't the awkward kid anymore who had to borrow shoes or borrow clothes in order to fit in. I was just a kid on the court being free. Yeah, the environment I was raised in wasn't the best. You have gangs, you have drugs, you know, you have prostitution. Yeah, you have a lot of that stuff is right literally in my backyard. It was, it's easy to get caught up in that, but basketball allowed me to get out. I went to a two-year school first, Citrus Community College. And then after Citrus, I went to a four-year Chaminade University of Honolulu. Basketball, yeah, allowed me to go places. It allowed me to go to a four-year university for free and get a diploma that most people from my area don't get. After I finished my college career at Chaminade, I was offered an opportunity to play in Romania's top division for Dinamo Basketball Club. After that, a couple years went by and I was presented with the opportunity to come to China. I'd never been to China, never been to Asia, so I took the opportunity and came. Ocean was a cool team. We played in the ABA, which is like American Basketball Association. We used to kill them. It wasn't fair, not at all. In the 3.5 years that I played with Ocean, I lost one game. The hard part about playing like professional basketball, playing for Ocean for any team, is it's really stressful. You only get a year contract, so you're year to year. Or most people know it's game to game sometimes. So if you have a bad game or two or three bad games in a row, you can go home. If you get injured, you're going home. So playing basketball on a professional level is very stressful. After the owner passed away, we had, I think 10 games, and then the team folded. It ended. For a while, I didn't know what to do. I just stayed in our apartment, trying to make a plan, trying to figure out what I was going to do, what was my next move. One day, I got a phone call from some friends to play what they call wild ball. By then, I didn't know what wild ball was. But as long as I could play basketball, I felt like it was a good idea for me to get out there and play.
All right, let's go.
Oh, let's go. The world of wild ball is eye-opening. I've been invited to play over 50 cities around China and travel to places you couldn't imagine. You wouldn't imagine basketball would be so important to these people. But whenever I go to play in these cities, I always try to bring my best performance to give them that sense of professionalism. For some of those that never get to see it. Most people don't understand like the joy and satisfaction that some of these farmers and workers get from seeing foreigners, period. So for them to actually see, a foreigner play basketball at a high level is life-changing. Only thing that sometimes gets to me is playing without a purpose. One day I'm playing for a company in one city, and the next day I'm off to a different city playing for a different company. So I'll lose my sense of purpose. It's hard on the ego, because you want to play for something, you want to play for a championship, you want to play for your friends and family, you want them to be able to look you up online, stuff like that. My former teammates are playing CBA, playing for the Beijing Ducks, winning championships, you know, with a real team. I never know who I'm going to play with the next time I play. The constant group of people around you and on a real team is important, because when you're in a country alone, you need those people sometimes when you get lonely. It's kind of like when you have a real team, you have that purpose. You fight for not only yourself, but you fight for your teammates, because you guys are warriors together. I really miss that part of basketball, honestly.
Reaves left open for three. He's going to take it, and he cans it with the ball over to Reaves, feeling it for three.
They say Wukesong has good feng shui.
Reaves.
It's true.
Wukesong
came to me
with
purpose in a time I didn't think could be possible. One day, Sean messaged me to play basketball at an event, and the event happened to be FIBA 3-on-3. They give me a sense of belongingness, you know, in a city that I've been a part of for 5 years. During the games, I formed a pretty strong relationship with the people at High Park. I've came across some good people who have been like family to me. Xu Jiaoxu, Sean, Lily, Julian, Ignacio, just to name a few. They helped me out big time. When I was going to Japan, I had to take like 4 flights, had to scramble, had to cancel a commercial game, a friendly game I was playing in a tour, and we all came together and we made it happen. August 3rd, Beijing Masters. We just had won the championship. My teammates and I were standing center court, being showered with gold confetti, just cameras flashing everywhere. And all of a sudden, I started to think about, you know, what my purpose was, like what I've been doing here. I've always wanted to be recognized as a good basketball player. As someone people respected, as well on the court and off the court. And in that moment, like being a hero in front of all those people, I kind of felt like my purpose was served.
Where'd you get that from?
This?
Tell them where you got it from.
At the aquarium.
Which aquarium?
Beijing.
Yes, did you have fun?
Yeah.
Yeah. That's so annoying. Turn it off.
No, it's not.
It is.
No, it's not.
The colors are nice, but the noise is so...
It's not.
No, it's not. Okay.
I don't like
picking. Because you don't like a lot of stuff.
A lot of people don't know I have a daughter. Her name is Malaya. She's 7 years old. I was only 22 when I found out from my ex-girlfriend that she was pregnant. As any 22-year-old would be, I was overwhelmed. However, the only thing I knew was that I grew up without a father, and I didn't want her to grow up without hers.
Stop it, girl.
It's cool!
Good, keep it off.
For me, I think having her was the best thing to happen in my life, and basketball has been my way of taking care of her and being, I hope she'd say, a great father.
I'm over here at the
MasterCard Center doing the video. Look at this. Three. One more. It's blurry. One, two, three.
My daughter is clueless about my life in China. I mean, my basketball career. All she knows is her father plays basketball in China. She wants me to come back home. She wants me to be with her in America. And I wish I could. All my daughter knows is that her dad plays basketball in China. She doesn't really know the gist of things that I do or the things that I go through in order to provide for her. All I know is every day that I'm here, I miss a day to be with her. Every time I leave, you know, I can see like it hurts her, like she cries, she doesn't want me to go. And I don't want it to get to a point where she doesn't want me. I feel like now is the best time for me to go back home and be a full-time father and be a part of her life and watch her grow and teach her things. And the most important thing is a foundation, and you know, teaching your kids, you know, the morals and all those sorts of things, and giving good advice, things I never had.
It's the first time I've ever seen this from her. She's a natural.
I've never been super famous or super successful basketball-wise based on, I guess, world standards. But I think me not getting these things internally has made me a stronger person. Basketball is like any other job. You have people at the top who get all the praise. You have people at the bottom who get no praise. You have people in between who do the dirty work and work hard every day in order to make things meet, to provide for their families. I feel like I'm no different. I'd be lying if I said it didn't bother me, that I didn't obtain those goals that I had set out for myself. But one thing I've discovered or found in myself is a purpose. I mean, my purpose with my mind and muscle, I'm comfortable with the way my life has turned out. And through these experiences, I feel I'll be able to teach my daughter. So this is my story. Story of an ordinary basketball player looking and serving his purposes. Wukesong has served as the purpose and the pinnacle of my basketball world. I am blessed by this lucky place, not only because it offered me the purpose and recognition I was longing for, also because this court enlightened me with the next purpose of my life, which is to be a good father for my daughter. Next time you come to Wukesong and you happen to remember my story, please stand still and spend a second or two listening. Let the lucky court tell you, what is your next purpose?